And today I have my sandbell for my dynamic warm-up. So yes, it adds a little something as far as load goes, but it's really nice to help either counterbalance in certain movements, as well as remember to keep your body fully integrated. So full body tension warming up here versus I'm warming up my shoulders and warming up my legs, putting everything fully integrated together. So I like it as a focus point. We're gonna start over. Hi, I'm Brittany Fowler with Hyperware, and today we have a dynamic warm-up with our sandbell. So I like it mainly for it gives you a focus point, and it also helps you fully integrate your body and get everything kicking together because we're a fully integrated system, not just one movement or one muscle group at a time, but really putting it all together, having a focus point, and let me start you out to get you ready for your workout. Then you can even use the sandbell throughout your whole routine. So from here, we're gonna start with something that's nice and basic, circling around the world, opening up the chest and the shoulders. You're circling the head with your sandbell. And we can add extra movement to this. So now as we circle around, we're gonna add in a side step, squeeze the shoulder blades back, warming up the back muscles, so kind of cracking a walnut in those shoulder blades. Circle, stretch, reach. Circle, squeezing back. Upper body is kind of getting moving here. And from here, we're gonna go straight into a basic squat. So the sandbell can be used as kind of counterbalance, help you work on warming up ankles, knees, and hip movement here. If you really wanna lengthen those arms out, challenge the shoulders a little bit more, get them warmed up. Almost like you're rowing into the body as you do that. From here we have high knees. I'm keeping the sandbell for now close into the body. You have the option of extending out or even adding more dynamic movement by giving you a focus point. Straight legs, again, giving you a focal point. Full body integration, we have shoulders, we have core, and we have stretch and work. From here, we're going into a wide stance for a side lunge. As you load one hip, hip knee toe alignment here. We're stretching and working, as well as working on your grip strength. So I want you to really grab into the sand versus just the rim of the bell. And that way you're ready for all those power movements or whatever's coming up in your routine. Grip strength. From here, we're down on the ground. So sandbell's in between the arms, you're in push-up, plank position here. Tighten the full body, a plank, or a push-up is a plank with moving arms. Warm up that body, stretch back. Use the sandbell to reach for the foot, or the shin, or the knee. Back into the center, warm up full body, chest, shoulders, core, and reach back. That sandbell adding load a little bit here, helps you stretch a little bit more. From that movement, come in and up. We have step back lunges with a stretch. Big step back. I want that sandbell to reach for that back half as you open up your torso and chest through the other arm. And switch the arms. Reach for that back diagonal. You're gonna feel that sandbell pull you apart, which feels really yummy, by the way. And switch sides. Again, reach for that back half, opening up the torso and the hip flexor. And switch. It's like somebody's pulling you apart. And back to center. From there, we have like a basically a frog squat here to upright pull. A little more dynamic. Again, working in the shoulders and the legs. Last row, we have our quickie, arm on our hop. And switch lead legs. And even coming from the side. And there you have it. So as you can see, I'm pouring sweat. I'm ready for my workout. Do it.
Give it one more try. You will make it work and then you feel it.